visiting Tasfirat Sulaymaniyah for over a year now since it opened. This year we've done 6 visits already to assess the living conditions as well as the treatment of detainees, judicial guarantees.
This, okay, so it's only one exhaust fan.
It's very wide-ranging, so it starts with the infrastructure but then goes on to include things like the actual rehabilitation programs that are in place for a given detainee, the food that's available, all the nutritional input they're getting, the health services, the relationships between detainees themselves, the relationships between detainees and the authorities.
It's also important that we see every detainee in the prison. We talk to the detainees for like in a group discussion or privately if they have some issues that they want to raise with the ICRC or an issue the ICRC can support them in.
The most important thing for us to have a credible discussion is to have information that's as accurate as possible. And the way we do that is to have as many sources of information as possible. One is the detainees and the interviews we do. The other is the authorities and what they tell us. And the third is our own observations when we're touring a place. So if we take those three and compare them to each other, we can start to have a full picture of what's happening.
It's important that we first establish trust because then they would allow us to enter the premises, meet the detainees, and then take our observations into account.
أني مرتاح حتى يراقبني أني مرتاح جدا أني أريد هذا يعني أني أريد مو مثلا بس قول الصليب الأحمر ومنظمات حقوق الإنسان ومنظمات الأخرى أي واحد يجي يراقب السجن يعني لازم هذا السجن يعني هذا شغل صليب أحمر وشغل منظمات حقوق الإنسان وغيرهم يتابعون هذا الأحوال السجن يعني هذا شيء زين بالنسبة لي يعني عندي إيمان بها وبس عندي ثقة بهذا يعني لازم أشتغل عليها إن شاء الله.
Changes in prison happen over a very long time, so it's kind of a long-term investment to see how different improvements in the places of detention can happen. In terms of conditions, you tend to see things like a reduction in crowding of the places of detention, a more consistent relations between detainees and their family members, and generally a bigger respect for judicial guarantees. So all the different requirements in terms of what should happen from when a person is arrested until they're eventually released.